2015 will be an amazing year for gamers. I compiled a list of potentially the best games that we will see next year. The list starts with the best towards the least best games that I think will be released in 2015. Dying Light is an upcoming survival horror video game developed by Polish video game developer Techland. It is to be released on the PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4, Xbox One, Xbox 360 and Microsoft Windows. Dying Light is a zombie apocalypse themed game set in an open world similar to South American slums and cities. During the day, players traverse an expansive urban environment overrun by a vicious outbreak, scavenging the world for supplies and crafting weapons to defend against the growing infected population with a heavy focus on free-running mechanics. Players can also customize the four characters in the game. The game is mostly melee-based, with the majority of fighting using melee weapons. There are more than 100 weapons that can be used, and more when players begin crafting new weapons. Dying Light contains a dynamic day and night cycle. During the day, the player has to go out and scavenge for supplies to send back to the safe zones. They can also set up traps, save random survivors, and make their way to airdrops. The infected are slow, allowing the player to simply make their way past them, but their danger grows in numbers. The player can stay on roofs of buildings to stay out of harm's way. Online multiplayer has been announced, along with the confirmation that there will be a split-screen cooperative play. It has also been confirmed that there will be a pre-order exclusive game mode that will allow the player to play as a zombie and join other players' world. When the sun goes down in Dying Light, the infected transform into something much more dangerous. They gain the ability to sprint after the player and have increased damage, as well as the ability to jump and climb buildings like the player. In order for the player to avoid contact, they need to use their night sense to locate zombies in the dark to stay out of their way. If spotted and trying to escape their pursuers, the player can use distractions and traps to lower their numbers. Players can use sound to lure the zombies. Batman Arkham Knight is an upcoming action-adventure video game developed by Rocksteady Studios and released by Warner Bros. Interactive Entertainment for the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One video game consoles and Microsoft Windows. Based on the DC Comics superhero Batman, it is the successor to Warner Bros. Games Montreal's 2013 video game Batman Arkham Origins, and the fourth main game in the Batman Arkham series. Kevin Conroy will once again voice Batman. Arkham Knight is scheduled to be released worldwide in 2015. The game's main storyline is set 1 year after that of 2011's Batman Arkham City and follows Batman at the peak of his ability as he confronts the supervillain Scarecrow, who has returned to Gotham City to unite Batman's enemies in a plot to finally kill the Dark Knight. Batman Arkham Knight lets the player fly Batman all throughout the city using his cape. Many gadgets and gameplay elements from previous Arkham games return, including the grapnel gun, line launcher and batarangs, the countering system and detective vision. Batman can use some gadgets while flying, such as batarangs on the line launcher. The character can fly throughout the city using his cape, with gliding now allowing for longer sustained flights, steeper dives and higher climbs. The grapnel gun can now be used to instantly switch directions during a glide, as well as being fired twice while in the air to chain grappling moves together. There is also a new batarang sensor that can be thrown out to gain intel on the surrounding area. Changes to the combat system include the ability to combine attacks on prone enemies without interrupting the streak. Batman can also counter enemy attacks and throw them into the other enemies for increased damage. Typical enemies are now capable of performing a charge and tackle attack only used by larger enemies in previous games. Precision time dodging and a batarang can instantly defeat some charging enemies. Batman can now access grates from far away, allowing him to roll forward and immediately get under the grate if in range, instead of having to be right on top of them, while also initiating multiple takedowns from within them. Arkham Knight introduces Fear Takedown, where Batman can subdue up to 3 enemies simultaneously as long as he remains undetected. Time is slowed after each takedown, allowing the player to target the next enemy. Hazardous items within the area, such as power generators, can be integrated into combat for environmental attacks. Batman is also capable of disarming enemies wielding items like baseball bats and using the acquired weapon on several foes before it breaks. Some enemies are armed with guns, which significantly damage Batman. The game also introduces a controller rumble-driven hacking minigame. Riddler trophies also return. The Order 1886 is an upcoming single-player action-adventure video game developed by Ready at Dawn, an SCE Santa Monica studio, and published by Sony Computer Entertainment, which will be released exclusively for the PlayStation 4. The Order 1886 is set in an alternate history London, where an old order of knights keep all of the world safe from half-breed monsters, who are a combination of animal and man. In the game's history, around the 7th or 8th centuries, a small number of humans took on bestial traits. The majority of humans feared these half-breeds and war broke out. Despite the humans outnumbering the half-breeds, their animal strength gave them the upper hand in centuries of conflict. Centuries later, humanity finds new hope in King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table. King Arthur and his like-minded knights take the fight to half-breeds, but Arthurson realizes it's a losing battle. Through a mysterious turn of fate, the knights discover black water, a mystical liquid that significantly extends their lifetimes and gives them remarkable healing abilities. Despite the new advantage, the half-breeds continue to win battle after battle, until the Industrial Revolution turns the tide. Inventors are far ahead of their time, inventing technologies such as thermal imaging, zeppelins, and wireless communications. New weapons belch electricity, ignite clouds of molten metal on top of enemies, and fulfill dual functions as fragmentation grenades and proximity mines. By 1886, the war still goes on, but the humans almost have martial law. A new threat emerges in the form of the lower classes rebelling against the rich and the social order, with the knights supporting the well-to-do upper classes and nobles. The game features four main protagonists from the same squad, who each has a given name, and the adopted name of one of original knights. The oldest is Sebastian Malory, the second to bear the name of Sir Percival, and a descendant of Thomas Malory, who in the 1400s wrote Le Monte d'Arthur, the definitive Arthurian text. A close friend of Grayson, he is one of the best knights in the history of the Order. Grayson is the third to bear the title of Sir Galahad, and has battled the Order's enemies for centuries. He views Malory as a mentor, Lafayette as a friend, and Isabeau as a potential love interest. Other than that, little is known about him so far. Isabeau d'Urgil is one of the younger knights of the Order, but is much older than her appearance of being in her late 20s. The latest Lady Igraine, Isabeau was Grayson's apprentice, and if not for her commitment to the Order, his lover. Marquis de Lafayette was a French military officer who fought in the French and American revolutions. His tactical expertise brought him to the Order's attention, and Malory approached him and convinced him to join the Order. Although the group's youngest, his globetrotting has given him a whimsical outlook on life that grounds the squad. As an apprentice, he does not yet bear the name of a knight. The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt is an upcoming action role-playing video game set in an open-world environment that is currently in development by Polish video game developer CD Projekt Red. It is scheduled to be released on Microsoft Windows, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One on 24th February 2015. The game will be third in the series, preceded by The Witcher and The Witcher 2 Assassins of Knights, which are based on the series of fantasy novels of the same title by the Polish author Andrzej Sapkowski, but take place after them. The gameplay is similar to that of the previous installment. The Witcher 3 will introduce a living open world larger than any other in modern RPG history. The setting is more than 30 times larger than previous Witcher games, requiring players to catch a sailboat on some locations and ride by horseback to others. However, fast traveling around the areas of known locations is also possible. The Witcher 3 has been described as 20% bigger than Skyrim. Each action the player does will affect the world, every quest has a plethora of options on how to complete it, and every outcome is different each time. Combat, like the second game, revolves around an action RPG system combined with the use of magic, and the recent trailer displayed that dismemberment is present in the game. CD Projekt Red anticipates approximately 100 hours for the completion of the game, 50 of them belonging to side quests and 50 belonging to the main storyline. The game also features a dynamic day and light system, realistic AI, responsive and dynamic environments, and much more. In an interview back in E3 2013, the gameplay producer of The Witcher 3, Marek Cimek, stated that the game will have around 80 monsters. The monsters will be unique and have their own AI, special moves and traits. The interview goes on to reveal that some monsters' powers and abilities will also change with the day and night cycle, similarly to how a werewolf would gain powers during the night of a full moon. This is supposed to incorporate deeper gameplay mechanics when monster hunting. During the closed E3 presentation in 2013, a quest was shown to allow you to have the option to hunt a monster that seems to be terrorizing a village on many accounts, while the elder of the village claims the monster is protecting the village. You're then given the choice to hunt this monster, and if you pursue this, you will be tasked to do certain chores to weaken this monster and proceed to hunt it down. Item creation and potion brewing still remains in this iteration of the game, but has been modified drastically from The Witcher 2 to bring a better experience to players. The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt also introduces some new mechanics, such as Witcher Sense, sea combat and horse fighting, swimming underwater using crossbow. Geralt can use his Gabriel crossbow to combine his Witcher signs with it, resulting in different projectiles. There are 10 Witcher signs, 5 original ones, each having an alternative form along with the original ones. For traveling around the extensive world, players can use horses and boats. Geralt can even use bombs and Witcher signs when riding over horses. Halo 5 Guardians, also known as Halo 5, is an upcoming first-person shooter video game exclusive for the Xbox One. The Halo franchise game is being developed by 343 Industries and published by Microsoft Studios. Serving as the sequel to Halo 4, the game is scheduled to be released in 2015. At E3 2013, Microsoft announced a new, then untitled addition to the Halo series, along with a trailer appearing to depict the post-Halo 4 Master Chief. After E3, Microsoft Studios Corporate Vice President Phil Spencer said that the Reclaimer trilogy has been expanded into a longer series of games, saying they didn't want to limit the Reclaimer story within the trilogy. Spencer also clarified in an interview with IGN that while the next-gen game was not Halo 5, it was a legitimate entry into game series rather than a spin-off. Bonnie Ross of 343 Industries confirmed the game's Halo 5 Guardians title and 2015 release in May 2014 Blogspot. The game will be exclusive to the Xbox One and run at 60 frames per second. On the departure from the Xbox 360 hardware, Ross noted that the Xbox One allows 343 Industries to broaden the game's scope and utilize the console's dedicated servers. Tom Clancy's The Division is an upcoming massively multiplayer online third-person shooter video game developed by Ubisoft Massive, Ubisoft Reflections and Ubisoft Red Storm under the Tom Clancy brand for Microsoft Windows, PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. It was announced during Ubisoft's E3 2003 press conference together with a 7-minute gameplay demo. The game is set to release in 2015. The Division is inspired by Operation Dark Winter and Directive 51, real-world events which revealed how vulnerable we, the United States, have become. Society has become fragile and complex. In the game, a disease that spreads on Black Friday causes the United States to collapse in 5 days. The player is part of a group called the Strategic Homeland Division, or the Division for short. This group was established to combat the threat brought about by the outbreak and are given direct authority by the President of the United States to do whatever it takes to save what remains in a massive multiplayer online situation, putting them against AI-controlled enemies as well as other players in the game. Quantum Break is an upcoming third-person action video game to be released on the Xbox One. Developed by Finnish game developer Remedy Entertainment and published by Microsoft Studios, the game will feature live-action videos blended with regular gameplay. The game was revealed with a teaser trailer during the Xbox One reveal event on 21st May 2013. A Quantum Break television series is also in production, with Remedy stating that how you play the game impacts the show, and the show informs you how to play the game. The game is played from a cover-based third-person perspective with time manipulation powers. Quantum Break is set in the fictional northeastern US Riverport University, where a time traveler experiment has gone wrong, giving the three main characters, Jack Joyce, Beth Wilder and Paul Serene, the ability to manipulate time. Paul Serene, for example, can see into the future to decide which choices to make in the present. Uncharted 4 A Thief's End is an upcoming action-adventure video game published by Sony Computer Entertainment and developed by Naughty Dog, exclusively for the PlayStation 4. Initially teased at Spike TV's PS4 launch event on November 14, 2013, a full in-engine trailer confirmed the title during Sony's E3 2014 press conference on June 9, 2014. The game is set to release in 2015. Several years after the events of Uncharted 3, Drake's Deception, Nathan Drake, who retired as a fortune hunter, will embark on a globe-trotting journey in pursuit of a historical conspiracy behind a fabled pirate treasure. Naughty Dog outlined the game's plot as his greatest adventure yet, and will test his physical limits, his resolve, and ultimately what he's willing to sacrifice to save the ones he loves. Dead Island 2 is an upcoming action role-playing survival horror video game developed by German developer Jaeger Development and published by Deep Silver for Microsoft Windows, PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. Techland was originally developing Dead Island 2, but instead they decided to focus on developing Dying Light with Warner Bros. Deep Silver went looking for a developer until Jaeger pitched the game to Deep Silver in summer 2012 and got the deal. It was announced at Sony's E3 2014 media briefing, which is more vibrant and lighthearted yet violent than its predecessors. Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege is an upcoming first-person shooter by Ubisoft. It was announced by Ubisoft on June 9, 2014 at E3. It is considered to be a successor to Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Patriots, which has been cancelled. Like all other titles in the series, it will focus heavily on teamplay and realism. However, there are major differences to older versions of the game, featuring a heavy multiplayer focus and destructible environments. A trailer at E3 2014 demonstrated a hostage rescue scenario, and the game has initially received positive reactions. Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoy my list, and let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll see you next time.